Guys, I'm going to be doing a quick tutorial on how to set up shots, or how the limiter says it's team set up shots, and for car photography, cinematography, videography, all that kind of stuff. Of course, our style of videography or cinematography, as we like to call it, is very desaturated and cinematic, being the key frame or main objective. I know everyone isn't a big fan of that, but that usually just how it goes. So we usually like to find locations like this where it's not too open, but you can also see there's quite a lot of depth using the buildings, and of course we'll probably change the time and weather to certain needs as well. Of course, they're kind of varied between your visual pack with your loaded 12 and anything from clear, foggy, overcast. All look very nice, but either overcast or clear is what we usually use. For this tutorial, I'm probably going to be using, let's see, we'll use Mansung's M8, which has the limiter set it's livery on it. Right now the visual pack isn't on, but once I turn it on you can see the difference. Of course, if there's any other tutorials requested about the visual pack or something, then it may be an option later down. So, and then of course there's setting up your shot. So I want to have this in a very nice open area, so here, so the camera has lots of space to move around. Then you will of course want to set up your actual vehicle itself, making sure it's washed and repaired, if you want to do any customization to it, and then of course set up. Of course, character, you've probably seen my character quite a lot in the videos, either in the background, smoking, drinking, all that kind of stuff, just to kind of make it more lifelike. A good go-to is the lean for emote. Of course, you can add to play around with it to make sure it's actually realistic. Of course, that's what I aim for, it's always realism. Actually, we're probably better using the front here. Yep, that's as close as I think we're going to get it. Of course, then the next shot is actually recording it, which is very important. So usually give this about 30 seconds, depending on what you're trying to showcase. That usually gives you enough time to do whatever you want in it. For example, have the camera fly around, do a close-up shots, do a landscape shot. That might take 10 odd seconds. We usually keep from our landscape shots 10 seconds, and any other shots like moving shots, B-rolls, down to 5 seconds, which is just enough for us to either slow-mo if we want it to last longer, or cut it down to fit with the music. But yeah, so the shot will usually look something along those lines with our character in the car. The next important part is actually going into Rockstar Editor. I'm just going to upscale my render resolution to 4K. This means I can get a much higher quality for such a small ratio, that definition of upscaling. You can really see this when I go down, and you can see there's not a lot of pixelization along the fine edges. This allows us to, of course, get a higher quality work, but that does mean our FPS will drop extreme amount. Of course, just bending your clip in Rockstar Editor, letting it load. Usually servers will have issues. I would recommend just pressing F8 and it will show you all the resources that have been loaded at the time. If there's any fail to read old resources, then I would recommend taking a screenshot to that, send it to the developer, or if you are the developer, stopping the resource or removing it from your server. Now the clip is loaded. I firstly like to go up into different field and adjust this to whatever you feel comfortable. I usually like 8% free camera. Right, 1.0 zoom and 2.0 zoom. That's where we like to go. Of course, for our main shots, we'd like to stay on that 2.0 zoom. And you always want to kind of keep the camera going in the same direction, and you never want the camera to stop moving. You want it to have either a slow pace to the side or up or down. You either want it to do a fast transition around but in the same direction in the next shot, and that will really help with the smoothness of your video overall. Of course, you can see a great deal of these examples in the 30 second showcase videos with the audio edits, like the C8 and the two door Jeep by Thick Customs. So for example, I'm just going to do a slow pan. Camera's going to slowly pan to the side, zooming out and facing up, making sure this corner has a small gap between. Actually, let's just put it there. So yeah, you want this tire to come down to the side where originally higher is way up here, and this corner's down here. And that's that kind of transition that I'm talking about. And then make this last forever how long you want it to be. So 10 seconds, for example, with a marker to cut off that seam, that is your seam, so make sure this has nothing on it. Then this will be your new marker for your new seam. Then you want to go find your new camera angle, so this next shot I may want to show off the nicely made rims or wheels, depending on where you're from. Same motion, same direction, just different place. Gotta drag that one for 5 seconds if you're to the top here. Again, cutting that off, making a new one. Then, let's see, I want to show off the taillights. Not going to make it come around, I'm just going to make it pan to the side. 5 seconds again, cut it off. I would usually spend more time on this, but this is only a tutorial, so I'm pretty sure you still get that idea. Same again, just always spin this one around and make it leave it zoomed out. And then all you want to do is smooth all these, and then you just want to turn off the middle clip. You want to turn off the easing so it doesn't do a weird transition when you're editing this in post, and you want to turn off the first blending easing on the beginning of each scene or clip, and that will help the camera not smoothly go into the camera angle. It will start off in the camera and then smoothly continue, if that doesn't make sense. And this is kind of where your final project would be. Of course, imagine this with the visual pack on. And that's basically the simplest form of cinematography. Of course, you would export this with the visual pack on. And well, that would be your final product. Of course, I've used one's tutorial, if you would like a tutorial on post editing, visual packs, b-rolling, I don't know, air cinematography, drift cinematography, or just general basics again for anyone that's more wanting a detailed version, that's probably fine. Of course, there is a Patreon for one-on-one lessons, which I know not a lot of people would like, but there is an option for people that want to get serious and want to learn from people that have been doing this for a long time. Of course, background of videos like how my character was running against a car, then you can apply for a filming crew, which is all voluntary, so it's all fun and games. But other than that, that's it.